We have seen so far this one, that is wire we have seen, war we have seen, band we have seen. So the usage of this we have seen, usage of this wired or we have seen, wired and also we have seen. So, and the supply zero we have seen, supply one also we have seen. So about this, if you have any doubts, you can ask on WhatsApp. So these topics we will see today. This try or try and possibly try one, try zero, and then try rich. So if we cover this, then we are covering all net data types. So that's the today's agenda. So as part of that, let us go to. Next type we have seen. This wire definition last in second session, I guess we have seen the definition here. It represents a simple wire doing an interconnection. Only one output is connected to a wire and is driven by that. That's the definition of this wire. Just try the keyword again, the way wire is a keyword, this is also a keyword. So it represents a simple signal line as wire. Unlike the wire, a try can be driven by more than one signal outputs. So what is that? How it is driven? We'll see shortly here with examples. This is strength levels we have covered. Okay. I'm just rushing to that try. Yes, let's try. So the keyword try has a function identical to that of wire. When a net is driven by more than one tri-state gate, it is declared as a try rather than wire. This, what is tri-state gate? This we have seen in the very first session or second session. I demonstrated on this tri-state here. For new joinees, let us take one more time here, just very quickly. So we have, this is inverter. And we have buffer. So if you connect here one this way control line, so that is becoming a tri-state gate. So similar to this, there is another inverter. So you have one more here, this one small circle here. This is again your control here. So in this case, when control is zero, this in is inverted. Yes, this in is inverted. When control is one, then only this in is made available here in an inverted form. So these are tri-state gates. So when we don't have this one here, for example, this one, if we represent something like a switch. If it is open, then we will not be having any here signal. So that is high impedance state. We call it as a high impedance state. So that is the tri-state gate. So this is a tri-state gate. About this, we are trying to study this in this today's session, that with the keyword try. This one. So the distinction is. For better clarity, that is one thing, and a few more things you will see with this small example. So here, you see this try out. this buff if 0, buff if 1. We have buff if 1, that is the gate G1. Buff if 0, that's the gate G2. This G1, G2 are instantiation names as part of Verilog HDL syntax. We can have names for the gates. Names, these are the G1 and G2 are the names for these gates. Without this, can we have names? Answer is yes. For primitives, that is default keywords or primitives, these are the gate primitives. When you are trying to use them, at that time, you can avoid this having names. It is for your convenience. But if you are instantiating here user-defined primitive, so at that time, these names are must. We have to have names here. If you are instantiating user-defined module, suppose there is a half adder, module HA. Yesterday, we have seen that module HA. So that HA, if you are instantiating, at that time, having a instantiation name is must. Okay, so this G1 and G2 are instantiation names. Now what we see here is this out is connected to, I mean, G1 is connected to this out, and G2 also connected to this out. So this out net is actually connected to this, two gets being connected to this out. So here, if you see this one, in this case, you have G1 gate, buff is 0, that is, let me take the other one. So you have buff if 1, buffer it is, and the other one is buff if 0. So this is the same control I can get here, but provided here you have the solution. So now this is both are given to the same net actually. It's out. That's what here is. This one here. So this is driven by A, buff if 1. So you have buff if 1 here. Can everyone see the slide? Can everyone? Any problem? Suresh, can everyone see the slide there?
Yeah, we can.
Yes,
see
yes, sir. Yes, yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Because some one guy messaging on WhatsApp saying that I am not able to.
Yeah. Just this is a little bit. Some time it is not like. Then again it is coming.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So. This one, if you see here, where I was here. So this is actually driven by A, and this is driven by the B, and we have there another this enable. So if you go here, you can put enable here. So in that case, what we are going to do is we are going to have this one here, this try out. Such one, because this is coming with, these are tri-state gates, buff if 1 and buff if 0 are tri-state gates. So here, we are talking the same here. Here the signal on net out is controlled by the control signal enable. You see, this is the enable, is a control signal. In the paint, we demonstrated this one, enable. And if enable 1, signal A is speed to the net out. That is obvious, because when this is 1, this enable is 1, then only this A is made available onto the out. So at that time, this is not made available. You go to this one here. So when this is 1, so this gate is conducting and this A is made available onto the out here. At that time, when this is 1 is passed on here to the other gate, but this is since becoming 0 here. So this is like open circuit. So this B is not, is now, because of this enable 1, and we have here inverter here, this portion. So this is, the output here is zero, because of zero, this is like open circuit. So B is not allowed onto this out now. So what is allowed now onto the out net here? Only A is allowed onto the net. So how many tri-state gates are there? This is one tri-state gate. This is another tri-state gate. So two tri-state gates are used, and these two tri-state gates are driving the single net here. That is called out. So in such scenarios, so it is advised by this language developers to use this try as a port here. So as a net, this net out net needs to be declared as a try. That is what the point here that I am trying to make. What this try is for. The way wire is used, everyone knows about wire. So far, I was just for revision purpose. I mention one more time here. You have anything that is, for example, you have your half adder, for example. So in this half adder, you have here A coming in and B coming in and some out. This is out, and there is a carry out. This is also out, output port. So since these are coming in, we put here like this, and since those are going out, we put the arrow here. So now the point here is, though we write them this one, this two, with a keyword input A comma B, we write here, but inside implicitly they are actually wire A comma B like that. So meaning what? This net input is actually it belongs to which data type now? Input keyword, it belongs to net data type. I think I am not confusing you people. One more time I will explain this one to the people, those who are not familiar with this. This one A, B, we have to declare in the language. This is for our black box purpose here on the paper, on the board, for black box purpose. But we have to interpret this black box as a language. So how we do? We have to have here something, some keyword. That keyword is for us input. So this input now, taking this A and B, these are declared here. A, B are type input. Or type input. What I am making a point is, this input itself is implicitly, it is actually pointing to wire. It is. What is wire? Now question that comes, what is wire then? Wire is a net data type. It's a data type. Wire is a net data type. Is there a keyword net? Meaning there is no keyword net. Under net, we have several data types that earlier I have shown here somewhere in this. Here, these are the all net data type. So in this net data type, you have wire, all this listed here, total nine that you see. So this wire is a one in this net data type. So this wire is actually pointing to them, those who are nets. These are what? We physically call them, physically, forget about the language. So this is a net. This net is driving this inside whatever the gates are there. So these are the nets. So these nets, in the physical nets, in the language, how do we represent? We have to represent. We need at that time data types. So that data type is called wire. Now this input we are writing here, but we are not writing explicitly wire. Since we are not writing explicitly wire for AB, compiler, that is Verilog compiler, implicitly treating A and B as a wire. That's the point that I'm making. So this is net. So likewise,
I have one question, Jake.
Yeah, sure.
So these two A and B are the inputs to the half adder, so that these are the physical inputs. So just simply we can write like input A comma B. No need to mention like wire, right?
Yes.
If you don't mention this wire, by default it will take as a net data type. Under net data type, this is like considered as a wire, correct, right?
Yes, yes. You are correct.
No need to mention like a wire.
Yeah, no need to mention like a wire. Explicitly, you don't need to mention. If you mention
what will...
No problem, right? If you mention, no problem.
Okay, Jacob. Thanks.
Yeah. Okay. Well, so the point here is the one care we have to take is this one. Let me take another. The point here is if that is scalar type, at that time, if you don't mention like suppose say you are writing like input, you have declared a input, and this input identifier is a A. So this A is a scalar type. At that time, if you are not writing, no problem. It is not going to cause a problem. This wire A is, if you are not writing, no problem. I mean, if you are willing to write. This wire, in case if you are willing to write, then what is that you have to take care? If it is another case, you take vector, and I take the input again. But this time, this input I am taking vector. This is the vector I am talking about. So vector size is 2. So again, this is A. But now, what is your desire? You want to have explicitly wire. So in that case, wire A, if you write, you are making a mistake. That is the point that I'm trying to make. That is the point that I'm trying to caution everyone. So this wire A, you cannot write. You also have to mention the vector size along with the wire. So that is here in this case, wire space 1 colon that 0. At that time, if you are willing explicitly to be your wire written there, then you ensure that if it is a vector type, then you are also carrying the vector size. Without vector size, simply wire and this variable name if you write, then if it is a vector type, then you are actually messing up the entire code. If that is a scalar, no issues. If you are writing input and explicitly also, if you want to have wire declared, then scalar 1 bit, and this is also 1 bit, no issues with that. But the problem comes when vector. So this problem in a design file, it will not come. In a design file, it will not come. But if you are instantiating, it will come. What I mean is, you have here 1 bit. 1 bit full adder. Now, in this case, 1 bit full adder, you have mentioned something like, input. That is 2:0. And you have mentioned here A. So, now what you are doing is other end, you are trying to write a 4-bit full adder using 4-bit full adder using this 1-bit full adder, this 1-bit full adder. So if you are trying to instantiate here, so at that time this size, you have to mention here while you tie, you are trying to tie here, suppose this is you. Okay. I'm understanding. Many may take it differently. I'm confusing, but I just put a full stop for this. This is called structural, structural level. At this stage, we are not actually discussing structural level of coding. So what I'm trying to make is, if you are instantiating this 1-bit full adder here. And this input, if you want to instantiate here, I mean, if you are using this input here, declaring again here, required here, suppose say. So at that time, you just cannot do simply wire wire A. Because here in this case, this A is of 3-bit size. And here you are thinking that you are making use of this input, that is A, in this 4-bit full adder. Just because you mentioned A, you think that you have actually, making use of this A here. But whereas this A is actually scalar type in this 4-bit full adder, it is scalar type. Let me take, I will make the things clear. So you have here, again, the same 1-bit full adder. This time I don't go to that structure. I'll explain differently. Input, you have here 2:0. Say this is your in. Okay, meaning what? Something this is like this. A of 0 in a vector way you are giving. Things you are giving in a vector form. This is not in. This is not A, this is in. So you are giving here in of 0 and the other is in of 1. The other is in of 2. So this is vector way you are giving. Actually, in general, how we practice so far A, B, C, like that, right? Separately vector. But this time, let us say, scalar type we practice giving A, B, C. Instead that, let us say, this vector type you are giving to this full adder. Okay? Now you get here your sum and your carry out. So now you are testing here in the test bench. In a test bench, what is required here? This input will become reg, right? This input will become. Now reg, this size is, this input will become reg. This variable is in. If you put like that, what you have done is reg, this in is here. It's a scalar. You forgot to mention the size here, this size. So even this needs to be mentioned here. So that size you have to carry here. So that care we have to take everywhere. Similarly, output instead of scalar type here, let us mention here output, out. Now this instead sum, I have here out of 0. Instead this one here, I have out of 1. Now in the test bench, what it will become this out? Out become wire. So if I don't mention the size here, without mentioning the size here. If I simply use this one here, that is out, output, out, it's out. If I mention straight here, simply out. Now, what is the mistake that I'm doing? The same mistake that I did here. That in this test bench, it is treated, this out treated as a scalar. Whereas in the design file, out is a vector here. So we have to mention explicitly 1:0 and then close. So like that. So the point here, what I'm trying to make is, why if scalar, if you are not mentioning, compiler will treat it as a scalar and it will consider, it will not throw any error. Wherever there are vectors, then you have to be very careful. That is the point that I'm making. Vector, the size you have to take care. The scalar, if you are not mentioning, then compiler will treat such unmentioned variables as a scalar type wires. That is the point that I am making. So the point here is, from here we are. Now coming to this. So this one is, we were talking about this one. This is very clear. This is being demonstrated in the paint. When enable is 1, A is steered to the net out and the output of the gate G2 is tri-stated. say open circuit. So similarly, if zero, then B is still to the net out, and G1 is a try state. So in such cases, if the buffers are controlled by independent enable signals, the output is resolved according to the respective strengths. This resolving with respect to the strength that already we have demonstrated in earlier sessions. So this is the point that we are trying to make. This try is used in such cases where your net is driven by tri-state gates. If two tri-state gates are driving the same net, in such case, try is used. This is one point that you have to make a note. Now coming to the try 0 and try 1. So this one, if the output of tri-state buffer is to be pulled up to the one state when tri-stated, it is declared as a net try 1. Similarly, it is declared as try 0 if it is to be pulled down to 0 state when tri-stated. I will take up this one example. You see this example, you will understand. Instead of going through this theory, you will understand from this example. You have here buff if 1. You come to this G0 gate. G0 gate is, control is enabled here and input is I. And net is, output net is O1. Similarly, G3, we'll take up this one here. In the paint, we'll take up. To understand better. So what we have? Go to this one. Remember this buff if 1. First, I am drawing this buff if 1. That gate name is G0. I have input I1, output O1, enable is a control. So that is for buff if 1 G0 gate. So G0 gate, buff if 1. G0, this is the gate. Gate name is G0. And I have here one control. The control is EN. And this one is O1, and this one is a I. So this is G0. Now coming to the other one here. G0 is done. So G3. G3 is also a gate, that is a buffer. And it has got I as an input, O2 as an output. Enable is a control. So the gate name is G3. That is also a buff if 1 type. So that is G3. I am going to have G3. This is G3. So this is driven by the same input here, I. So let us take the same input, I. So same input, I. And as enable, I think the control is also same. So control is also same. So we put a control here. Take this one, enable. And output here is, that is different here, not the same, this one, O2. So this is O2. Now, one more gate left, that is G1 left. That is, again, buff if 1, O3, the output is O3, inputs and control is same. So we have one more gate, that is a buff if 1. So let us go to that one again, G1, one more gate, G1, this is G1, input is same, input I, and this enable also same, and this one is, output is O3, output is O3. So now what more? This is a try 0 and try 1. Remember, try 0 is with O1, try 1 is with O2. But O3, if you see, that is wire only. So order-wise, if you come, O1, O2, O3, try 0, try 1, wire. So let us put here, try 0, this is for O1. And we have here try 1, this is try 1, that is for O2, and there is a wire for O3. So now what is that we have to do? So enable is first case, enable is 0. Let us say our I is 1. So what is that going to happen to this O1? So when this is 0, every gate here, if you see, that is 1. Buff if 1, all are 1. If you're looking at this one only, we can say there is no bubble here. There is no circle here. So meaning what, all this tri-state gates are buff if 1 type. If 1 comes, then only enable. Otherwise, tri-state. So this is tri-stated. Tri-stated means this one will not be seen here at the output side here. Is tri-stated. So I am putting Z for tri-stated. Now come to O2. Same case. It is also tri-stated. I am putting Z. Now come to this one here, O3. This is also tri-stated. But the point here is, if you see this one, this one, tri-0, O1, right? So meaning what? You tie this instead to tri-state, you tie it to 0. That is the meaning. Now, if you come to this one, the other one here, try this one, try 102, meaning if it is tri-stated, then tie this output to 1, this one, so try it to 1. And this wire is, since it is not try, with a try net here, it is simply wire, default net wire, so this is held at a tri-state only. Is that clear to everyone? If you have any doubts, you ask. You have to clearly understand this try 0, because so far we covered try. This is differently we covered, and now we are covering try 0 and try 1. This is one keyword. This try itself is a one keyword, and try 0 is the second one, and third one is a try 1. So in short, the summary is here. When tri-state gates are there and their outputs, you don't want to hold at a tri-stated stage. You want output to be 0 and the output to be 1. Accordingly, you have to declare the nets. I want my O1 to be at a 0 in case if O1 goes to tri-state. That is what my actual intention, my design intention. There is a O1 is a net, that O1 should not go to tri-state. It should be going to 0 when it is actually going into tri-state stage. It should be going to 0. It shouldn't be going to the tri-state stage. So that is what known to the designer. So designer at that time, he or she will pick this try, T-R-I, try, 0, the net. This net they will pick, and they will declare this O1 net as a that belongs to try 0. Similarly, there is a gate whose output may go to the try state stage, and designer don't want it to be there, and he or she wants it to be at 1. So in that case, they can use this try 1, and they. The net, that particular net that they want it to be a try 1, in case if it is that is going to the try state stage. So likewise, this try 1 and try 0 are playing role. I guess I made it very clear. So there shouldn't be any doubt about this. So that's what about this try 0 and try 1. So now what is left for us? Try reg is left. If you see this one, we covered here this try we have covered, where is the pointer? While we have covered, try we have covered. This wide R we have covered, and try R also we have covered. Try R we have to cover, we'll cover that. But there is nothing to cover here. Still I will take for that. But it is just like a wired OR logic only. But the covered things are wired, try, WOR, and WAN, and try 1, and try 0. supply 0, supply 1. All these wind power. So let us go to now try ridge. This is our try ridge here. This one straight I take to this one here. In the paint, last session we have seen there is something called PMOS, something called I was talking about here some parasitic capacitance. So this one is your VDD and this one is your ground. So in case if you want to model this one behavior, this is a capacitance behavior. So we go to this try ridge. What it does, if we have something like there is a charge here, you know, when it is conducting here, this is, you know, the total phi, phi what we say, one is characteristics, IV characteristics of this. There are phi regions, I guess. So there is a point where these two are conducting, this PMOS or NMOS, both are conducting. So at that time, part of the VDD, this current that is coming here, ID, will also take this path, also will take this path, and some part will go to the ground. So this part is charged to some let us say, some. So after this is disconnected here, something like this. It's conducting, this one is conducting, this PMOS conducting. This path it is formed because it is not conducting, suppose. This NMOS is not conducting here. This is the NMOS path. So if this is conducting, due to this capacitance, it's a parasitic capacitance possibly. So this is maybe charging here. But the moment even this is not conducting here, this is not conducting, meaning not conducting. So now this is PMOS is not conducting, your NMOS is also not conducting, suppose. At that time, the charge, what about the charge here accumulated? So suddenly it will not go to zero. It will take some time. It will take some certain amount of time. Or if it is conducting, then there is a possibility that it may follow this path. If it is driving to another here, some inverter or some other logic here, to that if it is connected, the output of this inverter is connected to next stage. So this charge may drive this the other logic also. So, but the point what I'm trying to make is this behavior, how do we model in the language? So this is with the help of this tri-ridge we model. This behavior we model with the help of tri-ridge. How we are modeling? Let us see this example. So if you see this carefully here, through this example, we have module, it's known to everyone, module, end module, because several times we took up examples in the Verilog. Everyone, everything will start with a module and everything will end with the end module. And this charge is a module name, and this out is an output, in is a input, control is a control pin that we have seen in a tri-state gates. Enable is a control. All these are user-defined. There is no keyword, nothing. Out, in, control are user-defined identifiers here, all this. Even this charge is user-defined module name. Now this output is a Verilog keyword in output. Output this out. And this I will come to try reg out later on. You come to input straight. If you are coming to the input here, your input is in and this control. In and this control. And you have buff if one. Earlier also you have seen what is buff if one. So you have this g1. G1 is a gate name, instantiation name. Technically we call it instantiation name. So and within parentheses, we are writing the same, this out in control here. So now the point here is, if we have this one here, what is that this extra try reg and out is giving us benefit? This medium is this one, this one. The way we have seen the strength levels, supply one, supply zero, pull one, pull zero. In last slide, last session we have seen. Likewise, this capacity storage strengths are there. Associated with this tri-reg. Tri-reg net. Tri-reg is a net data type. And we have with this tri-reg associated this storage strengths. Capacitive storage strengths. Large are large. Three are there basically. Large, medium, small. So large is the strongest and the small is the weakest. So in between is this medium. So say strength, the way we have seen supply one, supply zero, pull one, pull zero, earlier slides we have seen. Likewise, here this is a strength associated with this tri-reg. So what is the strength associated with this tri-reg now? This tri-reg, this output, earlier we declared try one as a O1, try zero as a O1, try one as a O2. Likewise, here, try instead zero, instead of one, we are having try reg. And with this output variable identifier out is associated. And the strength that we are associating with this net is medium level. So what happens? You see this simulation results. When zero, in is zero, your control is X. It's unknown, control is unknown, buff. This buff if one, you have to recollect your this one buff. You have your buff only, this is only when one, then this in is seen there. So what if it is X unknown? So this is also unknown, output is also unknown. That is what the point here we are trying to make here in this case. So this one here, this control is X, irrespective of your input, output is unknown. Irrespective of your input, output is unknown. Hope this is clear. This control is this buff. In a paint, we have shown that control, the top one is a control. When that control is unknown, then this buffer gate having in as the input. So if it is 0 or 1 or whatever, irrespective of this input, your output is unknown because this control is unknown. That is what the first result at the zero simulation time. Here we have this test bench also. We'll come to that. Now next, what is that happening? When in is 0, input is 0, and your control is 0, so what is your output? Output is X, meaning previously whatever that is there, this behavior has come, this X previously, that charge, this behavior, because of try reg, this behavior you can see here. Previously whatever is there on the output, that is this try reg is causing this behavior to be here, this simulation behavior to be here. Otherwise, This will go to the tri-state state, high impedance state Z. This in is zero, control is zero, your output is X. Now coming to your this one here, input is zero, your control is one. So you know that control is one. When control is one, your buff if one means when this control is one, then only input is seen onto the output. So your input is zero, and that is seen onto the output. So now similarly, if this is one, this output is seen onto the this one. What is that called? Output. But you see this particular behavior, the way this is behaving, this is also behaving. When you remove the control, you have removed the control. It should go to the actually tri-state gate. It will not go to the tri-state that is stage. This is coming as a one because previously it has charged to some strength, that is one. So since you have removed the control, it should have gone actually to the dead high impedance state, because you just removed the control. You see the control is zero. You have removed the control. If you have removed the control, then this buffer, this is a tri-state gate, it should have gone, this output should have gone to the high impedance state. But instead of going to the high impedance state, it is still showing the previously charged one here, this output as a one. This is previously charged one, is this behavior is seen just because of usage of this tri-reg. So that is what this entire tri-reg is behaving. If you this is the test bench related to that one here. When in is the same here about this simulation, when control is zero, output is x. So about this same whatever I have communicated, this straight output, this is the test bench. Out of this test bench only this has come actually. I hope let me summarize this one very quickly. This tri-reg is holding the charge onto the output net. Your output net here. This is your output net. This is O1. O1 is your output net. Output net. So now the behavior, how we are imitating. If there is a capacitor here, what happens if it is one, if it is one, and if it is one, since it is one, and the gate, looking at that, you can say that is a buffer. If one, then only it will conduct, it will buffer. So when it is one, it is buffering this one here onto the output net O1. So what is our idea is to imitate this capacitance behavior. So this one is coming here, it is charging here. This behavior we want to imitate in the language. So that is, we are making it possible with the help of try and this net name. Net name is here O1. And in between, what is there? That medium is the level, the charge level strength. Every wire has associated with some strength, some that last session we have seen. So that way, here it is having large, medium, and the other one. So that is the medium here in our exam. So now what happens is, if you remove this one here, this control to the zero, meaning if you're having here zero or one, whatever, that impact will not be seen here at the output side. Just because you have removed this one. And if you don't use this tri-reg, then what happens? It is just like a, just because tri-state gate, it is like this. Just because it is zero. The control here is a zero. So now you, irrespective of your zero or irrespective of your one, this net is behave, it will behave like a high impedance state Z. We don't want this to behave like a high impedance state Z. Earlier, whatever that has been charge accumulated here, maybe zero or maybe one, whatever the charge been accumulated, that charge we want to retain. So that is the idea here. So this charge we want to retain here. Meaning what? How do you retain the charge? Through capacitance. So this capacitance behavior we want to model. For that, this is helping. Tri-reg is helping. I hope I did not confuse you. It is clear tri-reg with this example. This buff-if is actually tri-state. The behavior will be like this. We don't want behavior to be like this. previously whatever we don't even want this one here to use try 0 try 1. What happens if you use try 1 or try 0? It will be tied to particular one here. If I use instead try reg here, if I use try 0, what happens? Instead going to try state here z, it will be tied all the time to the 0 if I use this try 0. If I use try 1, instead going to the try state z, it will all the time it will be tied to 1. I don't want this behavior also. I want previously whatever this has been, you know, the output has come. Previously if it has come 0, previously if it has come 1, that is the charge. 0 is some charge. 1 is some charge. The charge is accumulated here. When it will accumulate charge? If there is a capacitor. So that capacitor behavior, I want to model. I want to have it in a language. So that I can bring with the help of try reg. Is that clear now? I guess with this we wrap our session. Before wrapping this session, I just want to go here very quickly. We have almost covered everything. We have covered here all this 1 to 9 been covered. Only try or and try and there to take up for discussion. I have shared the slides. It is just like if you are using tri-state gates. What are the tri-state gates? Buff if 0, buff if 1, not if 0, not if 1. These are the tri-state gates. If these tri-state gates are driving more than one net, in that case, we have seen now in this case, where we have seen here somewhere in the try case, where is that? Try I demonstrated here. I think here. Oh, this one. This one is a particularly try one, this one. TRI, try. This one is used in the context of when more than one tri-state gates are used. See here. And these tri-state gates are driving single net. At that time, try is used. Similarly, try and are also used when more than one tri-state gates are used. But to resolve the contention issue, what was the contention issue we have seen, we demonstrated in the WAND, wired and wired OR. So there we demonstrated. Similarly, to resolve the problems of the contention issue, using the strength levels, we use triand and trior. Triand and trior used to resolve the contention issues in the tri-state gates. Tri-state gates, those more than one if used and more than one are driving the same. In that case, triand and trior are used. PDF I have already shared. Kindly go through that PDF. Still, if you have doubt, the left out I can take up, not an issue, because only we left with the that too for the demonstration purpose. Otherwise, already material been shared and the contention issue also already been discussed. So everything is done about this. So about this I'm talking about prior and this one. What is that? Prior and trend. This material already been shared and the contention issue with this wide and wide or already discussed. How contention issues. What is the strength level that is associated with the net? That also been discussed. So with this, I wrap today's session. I guess you benefited with this today's session. If you have any queries, you can ask. Otherwise, we can wrap the session.